A4988 driver tutorial, how to use enable, sleep, and reset pins for stepper motor control. Hello friends, let's discuss such an important topic when working with the A4988 driver, the enable pins. This driver has three of them. To work with the A4988 driver at an advanced level, as well as for just starting a stepper motor using this driver, it is essential to understand how these three inputs work. The A4988 driver is the most popular and affordable driver for bipolar stepper motors. It allows you to control motors with a current through coils of up to 2 amperes. It has a fairly progressive internal structure, with MOSFET transistors on the power outputs and regulation of the current through the motor. Let's open the instructions for the A4988 microchip. To better understand the further information, let's look at the graphs of the formation of control signals for controlling motors that are formed by the logical part of the driver. They are presented here for each of the 5 separate step division modes. We can see a clear correspondence between the shape of the current through the motor and the number of the input control pulse in order. We will return to these graphs later. According to the diagrams representing the internal structure of the driver, not much is understood about our pins, except that they are inverted. This means that their action is activated when a logical zero is applied. But further in the description, we can find their functional description in the text. Let's see what is written about the enable input. Enable input. This input turns on or off all of the fed outputs. When set to a logic high, the outputs are disabled. When set to a logic low, the internal control enables the outputs as required. The translator inputs step DIR and MSX, as well as the internal sequencing logic, all remain active, independent of the enable input state. In other words, by applying a logic high to this input, you can completely turn off the driver's power transistors. This way, you can completely power off the motor, reducing its heating when possible. This also disables active braking of the motor if we need to manually rotate the motor, for example, when we need to move the CNC tool to the starting position. But with an active enable signal, the logical part of the driver continues to work and form steps for the motor. And when we deactivate this signal, the motor starts moving at a random point of the forming step. This negatively affects the accuracy of the motor movement. As seen in the graphs, the starting point of the motor, after the resolution signal is applied, is of great importance for precise positioning. This is because the signal generating system of the driver remains active if the resolution signal enable is received somewhere in the middle of forming the first step, and the first part of this step will be skipped. Such omissions will accumulate during long motor operation and turn into a large positioning error. If a continuous motor operation is required, a logic low must be applied to the N input. Or, judging by the A4988 module diagram, it can be left unconnected. Let's take a look at the functionality of the sleep input. This input puts the A4988 into sleep mode to minimize power consumption when the motor is not in use. When sleep is low, much of the internal circuitry, including the output FETs, current regulator, and charge pump, are disabled. When sleep is high, normal operation and startup are allowed, at which time the A4988 drives the motor to the home microstep position. To allow the charge pump to stabilize when emerging from sleep mode, a delay of 1 millisecond should be provided before issuing a step command. This means that the sleep input has similar functionality to enable, but with the difference that it deactivates all of the driver systems, and it takes longer to emerge from sleep mode, up to 1 millisecond. For high-speed tasks, this delay may be too much. Therefore, for most projects, it's better to connect the sleep pin to a logic high or leave it unconnected. Similarly, this signal works more correctly when starting the motor for the first time after sleep. The startup always begins with the generation of the start signal of the first step. Such control will be maximally accurate from the standpoint of step positioning. The reset input is described as follows. The reset input sets the translator to a predefined home state and turns off all of the fed outputs. All step inputs are ignored until the reset input is set to high. In other words, when a logic low is applied to this input, the power transistors turn off, and when a logic high is applied, they turn on. There is only one important difference from the enable function. When a logic low is applied to the reset input, The motor control logic is correctly synchronized from the beginning of the microstep cycle. This provides a more precise start when accurate step positioning is required. This signal also works more accurately during the first motor start after a standstill. The start always begins with the generation of the first step signal. Such control will be the most precise in terms of step positioning. It is useful to understand and learn how to properly control these pins in your projects. We have learned that the three driver operation enable pins essentially duplicate one another's functionality, but with some nuances. It seems that controlling the driver with the reset input is the most successful option, as its operation is sufficiently fast and precise in terms of positioning accuracy. Try experimenting for yourself by disabling the driver when the motor is idle, and you will see how much you can improve the motor's temperature regime, and even the driver's temperature by simply activating one of these inputs. After all, it is often the case that they heat up more when the motor is idle than when it is in motion. We would be very grateful for your support, and we will see you again soon.